National Children's Science Congress, she took the role of the team leader and won the state level prize. Her self-esteem has increased. Now what she did is, she documented the biodiversity of the entire pond and presented in the National Biodiversity Congress. She won the first prize. So continuous prize winning increased the confidence level of the child. What I did is, I just mentored the child, not taught the child. I just mentored and supported wherever they needed. In a short period of 4 years, it's amazing to see when she completed class 10, in a short period of 4 years, she acquired nearly 40 certificates. Most of the certificates are winning certificates of state level, national level, and international level certificates. So as a teacher, I felt very proud. One fine morning, a letter from the joint director office came to our school, inviting the best presentations of the science, the best performance made by the science, please report it. I sent the bundle of 40 certificates to the joint director office. She also won Inspire Award also. She is a poor child, residing at the tail end of Puducherry. That village have inadequate bus facilities. That child got an opportunity to fly in air to Japan under MHRD Sakura project. All these things happened because of the mentoring we did in our school. Teaching is different from mentoring. All children are sitting, we take a chalk piece and teaching, that is different. Mentoring is identify the skill of the child. This child is good in drawing, this child is good in speaking. So identifying the skill of the child and giving repeated practice to the child, that is mentoring. I mentored the child, show the child fly to Japan. As a science teacher, I thought it as the greatest achievement in my lifetime. So serious things is happening in our school. From 2014 onwards, we adopted a special methodology that is called a research methodology in our school. What is every year we have to conduct 5 research projects. All research projects are about the environment of our school. So we have a compilation of nearly 40 research projects. All research projects are up to the standard of college, but the research projects are done by school children. So we adopted one theme. All research projects, if you are doing 5 research projects, 1 or 2 projects should be in water. So from 2014, we started the research projects. Research seminar, a seminar on research, drawing on water competition. So all water. In 2019, a letter from Jal Shakti Abhiyan came to our school, inviting for National Water Award. So we did put much pain. We just compiled the work, what we did in our school, and sent it to Jal Shakti Abhiyan. We feel very proud that entire nation, our school first, or Pondicherry school first. It's a great credit we felt, because we didn't put much pain and effort for applying to the competition. What we did for the last 5 years, we just compiled and we sent it to them, we got the award. So what my final word is, a teacher should be a teacher in the classroom. For all extracurricular activities, we have to identify the skill or talent of the student and give special training, coaching, then we can achieve it. Okay, what may be the quality of the mentor? I went to the blue book. The blue book is 68 pages are excellent. In that blue book, I find some words. The first quality, according to me, as a practicing teacher, the first quality of the mentor is, he should be easily accessible by the mentee. At any time, the mentee should not have any hesitation to call the mentor. If there is a gap between the mentor and mentee, it won't progress. Because we did a full scope project with the Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. In the full scope project, the child will take the photograph of the pollen grains and send it to the student. That is one project. It's a different project. But what I am saying is, in that project, at any time the child will ask a doubt for me, even on Saturday, Sunday, at any time, 8 p.m., 9 p.m., at any time, sir, is this the pollen grain of this flower? They will ask. I will say, no, this is not the pollen grain. you take it at a different angle, the photograph is not clear. So there should be a easy accessible between the mentor and mentee, then only we can succeed. The second point, the most important point is, the mentor should be a proactive one. Without proactiveness, no one can mentor the child. What is proactiveness? As a teacher, I speak in the angle of teacher because I'm a teacher. Who is a proactive teacher? Every year, we have a list of activities, Inspire Award, Science Exhibition, everything will happen every year. So the proactive teacher will get ready before 2 months. Before the arrival of the circular, he should know the science exhibition is coming, so we have to get ready with the bundle of science exhibits. So when the circular comes, he can easily guide the children. So only the proactive teacher can be a good mentor. Without proactiveness, we cannot be a good mentor. Then a mentor should be a good, knowledgeable person. All know, Inspire Award is also an exhibition, science exhibition is also an exhibition. In both the cases, they are presenting the model. But if you put the first prize winner of the science exhibition in Inspire Award, it will flop. It won't win. A mentor should know what should be presented in what type of component. Both looking from outside, both look like a exhibition. But Inspire Award is different from the science exhibition. So what to be present, how to be present, where to be present, all nook and corner should be known by the mentor, then only he can train the teacher. This year, every school can apply maximum of 5 Inspire Awards. I proudly say, my school, we applied 5 Inspire Awards. 5 awards itself get selected. From Pondicherry only, 70 to 80. Out of that, we have the maximum application level of 5. The 5 we get selected. The best thing is, I mentored the children how to do what to do. These things the mentor should know. Without knowing this, no one can mentor the child. The mentor should have a good communication knowledge. If the mentor has very good idea, but he didn't know how to communicate, means there will be a flop of the activity. So a mentor should be knowledgeable, a mentor should be easily accessible, he should be a proactive one, and he should have very communication knowledge. With this, I thank for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. It was really inspiring to know your journey as a mentor, and I don't need to show my next 2 slides because sir has already summarized what are the characteristics of a mentor, what are the qualities of a mentor, and how a mentor should be. So moving on to the next, I think this panel discussion is a culmination of what we say, that a mentor may be a teacher. A mentor could be between teacher-student. A mentoring can happen between an education administrator and an HM. A mentorship can happen in between the system leaders. So it can happen anywhere. It need not be just teacher-student, student-student, or teacher-teacher, or HM-teacher. It could be anywhere, and mentoring is something that is a mutual benefit for each individual who engages in this. And I let you guys to explore more about mentoring in the blue book. So thank you, panelists. We can move forward with the session. Ma'am, you want to add something?
So I'd like to thank here everyone for giving us opportunity to panel. From the experiences of the 3 mentors here, it's very clear that the need of the hour is in all the institutions today is mentoring. So with this, we thank everybody.
Thank you so much, panelists. Thank you for being so patient with me, because I know I was giving you for time. Okay. So this is the blue book, the index, the components that are there in the blue book. You will have a detailed look into the e-copy that you have. Please go through the blue book, have a detailed understanding of what is mentioned in the blue book. And this is, like I said, this is just a draft. We need to improvise more. We need your inputs, your comments on it, to be it as a collective book for our guidance for mentoring. So if any inputs that you have for the blue book, kindly mail it to them in this email ID, abhimanyu.ncte@government.in. Any inputs you have, please send them in this email ID. And for today, like, how did you feel about today's workshop or today's interaction that we've had on mentoring, we would love for you to share your feedback. So that feedback you need to share by scanning a QR code which is in front of you in the chair, okay? So there will be QR codes posted in the chairs that you're sitting. Just scan them with a QR scanner, press on that link, you will get into the link and fill the feedback for today's session. How did you feel about these 10 a.m. to 1:30 or 2 p.m. right now? Whatever your feelings are, please don't forget to fill in the feedback. Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for being patient. I invite SPD sir to give the conclusion.
I think before Kavita Madam gives her vote of thanks, so I request Honorable Director Sir to felicitate the guest that we received today. I request our Deputy Secretary Sir, who all the way from Delhi visited Pondicherry. I hope and I wish you have a good stay at Pondicherry, Sir. Hope you come back once again more enthusiastically with more, Sir. So I request our Sir to felicitate Sir with a shout, please. We have our Abhimanyu Yadav sir, who was also from NCTE, came along with the team. So thank you for coming to Pondicherry sir. Hope you keep on coming. Hoping you are there. So I think one person we have been constantly contacting is Mrs. Shella ma'am is there. I think I request our director sir to felicitate her in the show. Thank you. So with this, I think it is up to our Punita ma'am, who is the SPC, to give her a vote of thanks. Please ma'am, please. I think by looking at the papers, I'm afraid. I think it is wrong.
Pondicherry University and all the teacher training institutes
in Puducherry and all the inspecting officers for sending their representatives to this event. An event of this dimension cannot happen overnight. The wheels should have started rolling months in advance, but for this event, it is just a week. I am very much thankful to Deputy Director of Elementary Education for his involvement and the panel members for the active discussion. Thanks should also be extended to all colleagues who non-teaching staff members who always stand by us and motivate us. I feel proud and thank you for making this event a grand successful one. Thank you, one and all. Thank you.
I think with this we end this meeting. I thank all the participants who came from all the paid colleges and faculty, taking all the efforts to bring out them. Thank you, one and all. I hope this meeting ends. Okay, if it is further, then. I think that a small token of this thing, I think for chairperson of the NCTE and our honorable member secretary of NCTE, we have a small token of love from Pondicherry. That our students have prepared a samples where that best of best from the waste. These art pieces are given from as a token of love by our honorable director, sir. I think we request madam to pass it on to chairperson NCTE for as a kind of token of our love from Pondicherry. Sir, nothing's above it, sir. In this category. Thank you, ma'am. I think I request the same momentum can be carried forward to the chairperson in CTE from our side also. Thank you. Thank you, and thank you all for being a part of it. Thank you.
Yeah.